What is up, guys? It's Tom here and welcome to the West Ham United Liverpool post-match analysis show. Let me know, what did you think of the game? Who was your man of the match? Leave your comments down below. And also, where do you think Liverpool will finish this season? Because the Premier League is so competitive. The top six is really standing out at the moment. Liverpool are in sixth place, but only Chelsea and Arsenal are ahead of them, only on goal difference. And why it was so important for Liverpool to win this game is that Chelsea play Manchester United and Arsenal play Manchester City tomorrow, so both teams could most likely drop points, and Tottenham play Crystal Palace. They will probably win that game, so it was vital for Liverpool to get closer to the top four. And we need to build on this. After the international break, Liverpool play Southampton and another 3 points there, and we could be above Chelsea by the time we meet them at Anfield. That will be another huge game. Liverpool, you know, were really lethargic in the first 20 minutes of the West Ham game. As somebody said after 90 minutes that Liverpool will score 4 goals today and they could have scored 6, I would have sent them to the mental asylum or something like that, because Liverpool didn't create anything. In the first 20 minutes we were slow, we were sluggish in possession, we mostly passed it sideways or back to the goalkeeper. And actually, West Ham should have taken the lead in the 10th minute when Andre Ayew goes through. It's a pass from Lanzini, who had a good game from West Ham, which ricochets off Chan to Ayew, and he lifts it over Mignolet, but it hits the post. And that was the kind of block, the kind of break that Liverpool needed, because if West Ham go on 1-0 up, I could see the Liverpool heads dropping a little bit, especially with our recent wretched away record. We conceded 16 goals now in 6 away games, but before this game we had 15 goals conceded in 5 away games. That's the most by any side in the Premier League. So yeah, Liverpool need to shore up the defense. But it was actually from a West Ham corner where Liverpool, 13 seconds between West Ham taking a corner at the Liverpool goal to Liverpool actually scoring a goal on the other end. Can you believe that? That is absolutely incredible, in my opinion. And yeah, it was actually Salah who picks the ball up from the West Ham corner. He passes it to Mane, taking a West Ham defender out of the picture, and then they just run at one defender. There was only one West Ham defender who was panicking. Salah and Mane, when they are running at you with pace, with the ball, you don't have a lot of hope in life, to be honest. And also Oxlade-Chamberlain was closing in on them, and Mane was so unselfish. When he got to the 18-yard line, he passes it to Salah, who takes a touch, has the composure to put it past Joe Hart. Brilliant finish. And what a signing Mohamed Salah has been. Last summer we signed Sadio Mane, and in my opinion, Mane was one of the top 3 signings of the season in the last summer transfer window. This summer transfer window, so far, it's not even a contest. Mohamed Salah is the signing of the season. He scored 7 goals so far in the Premier League, 12 goals in total, 3 assists. In 17 games, he contributed to 15 goals at Liverpool, and only Aguero scored more goals. Only Harry Kane scored more goals in the Premier League. Salah scored as many goals as Lukaku, Aguero. So yeah, Salah is the second top scorer in the Premier League, and Liverpool actually are the third top scorers in the Premier League. But also Liverpool conceded like the fourth most goals in the Premier League. So it's crazy. There has been, you know, 21 plus 17, that's like, there has been almost 40 goals, 38 goals in 11 games at Liverpool games. 38 goals in 11 games at Liverpool games, during Liverpool games this season, just in the Premier League. Absolutely mental, absolute madness. So what do you think about that statistics? I'm just getting, to grips with that. So Salah scores the first goal, and just 3 minutes later, we got, I think, a little bit of a lucky goal, because the ball was whipped in from the corner, and actually hits Mark Noble's leg. It bounces off. Joe Hart makes a reflex save, but Joel Matip tucks in the rebound to make it 2-0 Liverpool. And after that, you know, we slowed the game down. We're really controlled in possession, passed the ball around. Didn't create much for the rest of the first half. But Mignolet, I mean, why is he captain, first of all? Why isn't somebody like Joel Matip captain? Or even, I don't know, like Firmino could have been captain, but to make Mignolet captain after Henderson getting injured, you know, and Milner not starting, that just blows my mind. Because Mignolet is just not a leader, in my opinion. And also, he makes another incredibly stupid, dumb decision, just dilly-dallying on the ball. When he has the ball, he tries to see it out for a goal kick, but Lanzini gets there, nicks it off Mignolet. West Ham get a throw-in and they actually get the crowd up because of Mignolet's, you know, hesitancy. His decision-making is just garbage, in my opinion. That's the nice way of saying it, that it's really bad. And I would love Karius to get a run in the team, because I think he's a much better goalkeeper in terms of playing out from the back than Mignolet. But, you know, Mignolet didn't cost us the game today. And yeah, in the second half, Liverpool played even better than in the first half. The first half was an okay performance. The second half was an outstanding performance by Liverpool. But, you know, West Ham got to go back. Joe Gomez, he showed his inexperience a little bit, but he's still a young defender learning his trade, where he ducks under the ball. I'm not sure why. Maybe he thought that Lanzini wouldn't be able to get the ball, but Lanzini is just behind him. He gets the ball and he lifts it over Mignolet. It goes in off the far post and West Ham suddenly have a goal back. And that lifted the whole stadium. And I will be honest, guys, I was worried that West Ham will actually come back in this one, because Liverpool's defense looked shaky. West Ham created a couple of chances. They brought Andy Carroll on for the second half. But just 30 seconds after the kickoff, after the West Ham goal, Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain gets his first Premier League goal of the season, and he has been playing pretty well in the past few games. He had some games where he wasn't up to the standard, especially the Leicester away performance when we went out of the League Cup, a 2-0 defeat. Oxlade-Chamberlain had a shocker in that one. But since then, he really upped his game and he looks like the player that Jurgen Klopp wanted to sign, and sign in the end for 35 or 40 million pounds. I don't think he's worth that much, but Oxlade-Chamberlain is only 24, I think, 24 years old, maybe 25. So maybe his best years are still ahead of him, and he is a crucial player in Liverpool's team in terms of going forward. In the long term, for the next 5-6 years, if Jurgen Klopp can improve him, and I'm sure that he can, because he improves almost all of the players except the defenders but all of the midfielders and the strikers improved are under Jurgen Klopp, in my opinion. So Oxlade-Chamberlain, you know, he gets the ball from Firmino in acres of space. He has a first time shot, Joe Hart saves it, but the rebound goes under, goes back to the Ox, and it goes under Hart's leg, and that was the killer goal. At 3-1, just half a minute after West Ham scored, that killed off West Ham's momentum, it silenced the stadium. And of course West Ham brought on Arnautovic, Diafra Sakho, forward players, but it was actually Mohamed Salah who stole the show after, you know, waves and waves of counter-attacks. Milner should have scored, he missed the target. Firmino was also doing a brilliant run past three West Ham defenders. He goes through and narrowly misses the target, and Firmino really deserved the goal for today's performance, because he had such an outstanding game. His work ethic, Firmino, I'm applauding that guy. He is just immense. If any of you guys played 11-a-side football and you watch with Firmino's work rate, how much he runs, how much he hassles and harries defenders, and how much he high presses, no wonder that Jurgen Klopp loves him to bits, and that's why he is starting out of storage. Because even when he's not scoring, not assisting, he runs the defenders into the ground and he never gives them any minutes to settle. Special mention to Firmino for today's performance. But Mane picks out Salah at the far post. And again, Salah, who is one of our most dangerous players, is left wide open. By the time the West Ham defender closes Salah down, it's already too late. He already gets his shot away, and it cannons into the bottom far corner like an arrow. Brilliant by Salah. He gets his second goal. Mane, who was probably just 50% fit, but Jurgen Klopp thought that he should play 77 minutes. I would have maybe brought off Mane a little bit earlier, but what do I know? Mane assisted Salah in the 75th minute to seal the 3 points. So maybe Jurgen Klopp was right to give Mane the fitness and the minutes that he needs. And Mane, on 50%, got 2 assists today. Salah scored 2 goals, man of the match. And now Liverpool finally can hopefully build some momentum. We had some really bad results, the Tottenham and Man City result, the 5-0 and 4-1 defeat, really, really hurts. But apart from those two games, in all the other games, actually, Liverpool performed pretty well. We were very, very unlucky against Watford, against Burnley, against Newcastle, where we really should have scored more goals. And our defense, from 1 or 2 mistakes, it got punished. And also today the defense was a little bit shaky as well. This West Ham side, which are not a great side, could have scored more goals against Liverpool. But going forward on our day, we can score 4 goals like you have seen, and we could have scored 6 or 7 today. I just really hope that we can beat Southampton, who are in a really bad run of form at Anfield, in 2 weeks' time, and then we can put pressure on the top four, maybe even get into the top four before the Liverpool-Chelsea game. And who knows, if we can beat Chelsea at Anfield, which I think we can do, because Chelsea are not the Chelsea of last season, and I don't see Chelsea beating Manchester United tomorrow, but we shall wait and see. Mourinho will be really up for that game. They have a big rivalry between them, Conte and Mourinho, so, but anything can happen in that game. But yeah, Chelsea, hopefully, they can be rattled at Anfield. And then, if Liverpool beat Chelsea and beat Southampton, that's 4 wins in a row, and then we can really look up the table now and challenge the top three. That's my hope. But, you know, Liverpool have to answer the critics' questions about the defense week after week. Let me know what did you think of the game in the comments below, and Fanzo live reactions coming soon. Stay tuned. See you later, guys. Good night.